Hello YouTube, I'm back again with another video. I did say I wasn't going to play my Animetta deck again, but I want to be able to show you something interesting that you guys might approve. It's not me, it's actually my opponent that I'm up against, even though I'm going to summon something really big after and make this huge board that is just going to simply just do a lot of collateral damage. So he's playing Digimon actually, I'm actually impressed. And at the same time, I'm trying to help him with his deck. So he came like forward, wanting to asking for any suggestions, any advice, what he could do to improve this archetype. And he's a little bit slow. I told him, like, why do you have to discard two cards to add one Digimon from your deck to your hand? It would have been a lot better if you were to discard two cards, then you should be able to get more monsters. And I understand it is a quick play. It just seems too weak, in my opinion. Or there could have been several ways he can improve this card. Discard up two cards, add that many Digimon monsters from your deck gen up to the number discarded. And the thing with the issue also, I think a lot of his cards don't have identical names. Their names do not relate to what he's playing because it makes the deck that less consistent. I am giving him feedback. And he's aware that eventually he's gonna have to edit his cards to do some improvements, which he does. He clearly needs to do. Let's fast forward here. So I'm guessing the reason why he made discard two cards was to be able to play one of his other cards. I'm guessing so. So which can be good if you make certain cards that blend in well with other cards, so they have some type of synergy, then it makes sense. But it should be optional where you if you decide to discard two cards, you add them in Digimon cards, and they have to be more specific. Because the reason why I say you have to have a specific name for a card, so that the card itself becomes more accessible, and that you have and then become more useful. You understand if you guys are into you, you understand a lot better. So he has an interesting card called Shield of Courage. I'm not even too sure what that is, but it sounds interesting. So this is his only play right now, which is very disappointing. I'm guessing his plan was to protect Gazimon, but he's trying to make his deck more balanced. Yes, you could say you respect a player who tries to make their cards more not as broken, to be more playable, but at the same time, that it doesn't hurt your opponent, it doesn't prevent you from playing Yu-Gi-Oh, but there are times where you need your deck to actually be able to compete. Maybe have like one or two negates, summon a bunch of monsters, but as long as those monsters do not prevent you from actually playing it, unless you have counters to those cards. They can make effects where the cards cannot be targeted or destroyed by card effects, or they cannot be removed the field by card effect, and you still have a chance of playing. But at the same time, it depends how strong that monster is too. You have to also think about it. It could be a monster of 2025. It can be unaffected by card effects, but it can still be destroyed by battle. And you'll see I'm about to go out on my opponent. I activate Sekai, and then I accidentally misclicked, so I'm going to go back in to normal summon Tanjiro and his effect. Pretty sure you guys are aware. Gonna pay 1200 life points, special summon two Animetta monsters from my main deck to the field. You should figure who that is. It's gonna be Hisoka and Deku. Deku's effect will activate, and I'll chain with Sekai, allowing me to special summon zero from my deck to the field. And then I add Yusosuru. And then I link into Motoko, and then activate Boken to add Uzumaki. And then I'll activate Uzumaki to the Pendulum Zone, destroying itself and allowing me to set two Pendulum Scales. But Pendulum Monsters to the Pendulum Scales, it doesn't have to be different names, but in return the restriction is I can only special some Animetta monsters that turn to activate this effect. So we're waiting on Lelouch. So I'm going to activate Akami's effect, just pop itself, allowing me to draw two cards. And then I activate Kirito on the Pendulum Scale, allowing me to serve some Lelouch. Lelouch's effect will activate, targeting Gazimon, and I gain control of that monster. And let's fast forward here, and I link 3 into Gilgamesh, and now special activate Dudiuso, allowing me to special summon 3 Animata monsters from extra deck to the field, and I get to draw for each one special summoned. So that's 3. I still haven't got to use Ahsoka's effect. Eventually I will do that. It's going to be game from here on out, so I synchro summon Saitama. And then I'll be able to draw that many cards, thanks to Ahsoka's effect. -2, excluding him. Then activate Zero's effect, allowing me to fusion summon into something more powerful, Goku. And then I'll pendulum summon 2. I'll go into my rank 4 XC monster, that's Kaneki. I use Motoko to gain additional pendulum summon. I'll link 5. And I pendulum summon these 2. And from here on out, that should be game. I apologize to my opponent. Hopefully he can learn from this. He can be able to update his deck. And it should be game, honestly, guys. And to be honest, I feel like this is the best duel I had. Or I mean the best combo that I constructed with this archetype throughout all the Animata past duels. And we're still talking. He admits it's a good game. He leaves the duel. And supposedly he was excited. He was happy. He didn't have an issue. There was no complaints. But again, hope you guys enjoyed the duel. Be sure to check for more upcoming content in the future. Be sure to check your notifications. Comment, like, subscribe. Thank you.